Time for another video game chronology. This time, we will look at a series that has been running for about 12 years now, Kingdom Hearts. This is a series that has a fairly detailed and already laid out chronology over various sources, so there is little room for debate. Mainly taking information directly from the Kingdom Hearts Memorial Altmania alone, we can lay out all currently released 8 titles, which are considered official in the series. Now, while we lay out the chronology here, we'll go in order of their initial release dates, just to make things more interesting. Okay, Kingdom Hearts 1 begins, and Chain of Memories occurs directly after it, with no time in between the games at all. Next, we have Kingdom Hearts 2 released, taking place nearly 1 year after the end of Chain of Memories. More precisely, it would be 258 days later or less after the end of Chain of Memories, but approximately 1 year. Then, to explain those 258 days in between, perhaps one of the most confusing parts of this series' chronology is Kingdom Hearts 258 Days Over 2, which takes place during the final parts of Kingdom Hearts 1, all through until directly before Kingdom Hearts 2. The end of Kingdom Hearts 1, Sora liberates his own heart using the Keyblade of People's Hearts, and thus Roxas is born. Days shows Roxas on his very first days of life, and all through until the events leading into Kingdom Hearts 2, where Roxas is the main playable character at the beginning of the game, showing his final 7 days. Then we have Coded, which doesn't really have any huge impact on the timeline itself, but its events occur shortly after the end of Kingdom Hearts 2. Next released was Birth by Sleep, which takes place approximately 10 years prior to Kingdom Hearts 1, where Sora, Riku, Kairi, Miki, and many other characters can be seen in their younger years. Many of the events in Birth by Sleep really open up a lot of information for what has become known as the Dark Seeker Saga. Next, we have Dream Drop Distance, or 3D, which takes place shortly after the events of the ending of Coded, which lead directly into this installment. Finally, we have Kingdom Hearts Key, which takes place far in the past, long before the time of Birth by Sleep. Now, people familiar with the Kingdom Hearts series may begin to have a problem here, as although the official sources state Key is long before Birth by Sleep, there are various oddities that people may notice, which include, but are not limited to, the player appears to be traveling between worlds, Hercules is already an adult, Emblem Heartless exist, Gummy Ships exist, Mickey, Donald, Goofy, Cloud, and many other characters who don't seem to be thousands of years old in the rest of the series already exist, among various other things. Of course, depending on how the story actually plays out, or whether or not 100% of the events in Key actually take place or not, these may not be problems at all. Then, we have the anticipated Kingdom Hearts 3 coming up, which has already officially been stated to be the latest in the chronology, an unknown time, likely not too long after Dream Drop Distance. So, the chronology of the series would look something like this. As stated earlier, the only thing that really could be confusing is Days and how it overlaps with Kingdom Hearts 1 and Chain of Memories. Everything else, I think, is pretty straightforward and already has an official explanation. Alright, until next time.